Ready?
Uh-huh.
Let's go. Rise of the Resistance. It's a ride. It's a Star Wars ride. It's very exciting. I've heard. I've heard good things. I've also heard the guests not wearing their masks properly will be asked to leave.
You know why that is?
Huh? You know why is that?
Because it's a rule.
It is a rule.
And you have to follow the rule.
Yeah.
You want to play.
They should change this. They should change this land. Land Avenue.
Generic American City Street Land.
Any town, USA. Wait times do look crazy. We actually saw a guy curse out a cast member because the line for Rock and Roller Coaster was so long. Not an improper response that would be on behalf of the guest, by the way. Here we go through the contemporary resort-shaped hole in the wall.
Yeah, we can put a monorail.
That would have been a good incorrect fact that the contemporary was like rammed into that cave until it became an opening.
Contemporary, then you need the dolphin, the black.
No, but the shape is the contemporary.
Yeah, but you know people say, oh, the dolphin has that part because they were going to put a monorail.
Yeah. Excuse me. We're gonna go past all these people blocking the entrance.
Thanks for joining the class.
Why do people, like, all of those people feel they need to block the entrance for the people who, you know, have a boarding group? Like, same thing people stop in doorways. Like, human consideration. Like, if there's one family already there blocking half the way, don't block the other half with your family. I spend most of my day so worried about offending someone else. But I just don't understand why other people just don't care. Say that, like, you know, you can ask him off to the side. Like, you can even go, like, on the rope side and ask a question. Clearly, you're blocking the entrance. Look, rebel poster tubes. I think that's what they are. Those people I don't even think had one. They're just like asking questions when, you know, you can ask any cast member just about in the front of the park. I mean, there's plenty of guest experience team or guest relations or whoever who will tell you the same thing. They'll tell you like you got to do the 2 o'clock or you need a boarding group or, you know, like, those two families didn't even know what a boarding group was the larger problem, is because Disney doesn't do a very good job informing people of the system ahead of their arrival. Those people honestly may not even know what this ride is. I'd just be like, what is this Star Wars ride? How do I get on? Well, you need a boarding group. I mean, you could get rid of the boarding groups if the ride functioned properly. that the ride doesn't always function properly, which I think is the issue. But whatever the perfect system is, no one has figured it out yet. I think that's a fair summary of the situation thus far. Joe, that's a good point, Joe. Oh man. Oh, we hit the queue. Very noisy today. I mean, they didn't extend. I think they didn't extend hours at studios because there's not more to do. Like, it's still the same amount of stuff it was. So, and you can't really let more people in because you're not opening more stuff. And so I think they've decided that 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. is more than enough time to accomplish everything in this park.
I mean, it's not with the lines.
I think with the lines you can, but you just have to wait in them. But I think even if you waited in all the lines, you'd get everything done. Because Frozen isn't even an addition, right? Because they got rid of Disney Society Orchestra.
Yeah, so. By Disney Society, you could walk in 2 minutes before Frozen. We're going to have that's to wait correct. 30 minutes.
At least,
minutes.
Yeah.
We're
going
to have to wait a show.
Yeah, that's fair. Guys at home, please hit the like button as you join. The like button helps other people find the stream. Helps us out. If you haven't yet, please subscribe. We'll be live from a Walt Disney World theme park, resort, or Disney Springs every day. Heather, we've had success with LTE and Wi-Fi, so it really just depends on your provider or the Wi-Fi on that given day, but personally, I use LTE. I'd also like to make sure I'm in a spot with full bars. Nope. Yeah, less hours, less payroll, but at the same time, like, they are extending other parks, which means more payroll at those parks. So, I don't think there's a good reason to extend studios. I don't.
I have one good reason.
What's that?
Sunset Boulevard at night.
Oh, yeah. But think about it this way. I think they've hit their stride finally. I think operationally, it's the first time they feel like they're somewhat in control of this situation. They've established a 10 a.m. open. They've established a 10 a.m. boarding group drop. It, for the most part, you know, is more well established than the process ever was at any other point. With the 10 and 2 drop, you're not adding another drop at this point. Like, I think they're just like, this is okay. Like, Skyliner operations are set where they're set. I think at this point, it's just like, we're just not going to rock the boat. We're not going to rock the boat on this when we think it's finally working as best as we can get it to work. I mean, in their eyes, I'm not saying they absolutely have done that, but in their eyes, they might believe that in their own mind. Yeah. I think there's other factors too. I think there's transportation factors. I think when the parks opened, there was a very deliberate decision to space all the park openings out by an hour. And so I still think they're fighting with that a bit. I think that's almost why Animal Kingdom 7 a.m. So the Magic Kingdom moves to 8 a.m. You then have this at 10 and Epcot at 11.
Best deployment?
I think it's all interconnected. I think there's enough good reasons in their mind not to extend this park in any direction. Thank you, DZ Studios. I see a red icon with a cross. I was thinking Secret Swiss Bobsled Training Facility, which is actually the shirt I'm wearing today. Secret Swiss Bobsled Training Facility. It's on. Stop. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I mean, I saw flight. What was flight of passage this morning? 100 and what?
95.
Oh, 95? Yeah, almost. Yeah, 95 minutes at open for flight.
We're going to go real early tomorrow.
Yeah. I love waking up early. It'll be great.
I don't even know how to wake up early anymore.
Just look at these Rebel poster tunes. At least I think that's what they are. Told a lot of people couldn't understand my Randy Newman singing, but that's part of the character, I think, of Randy Newman.
Sure, that's not sausage.
I don't think that's sausage. Chewbee the merchandise bird. They said it's already at 110 minutes, yeah. That's actually down. It was 120 at one point.
Yeah. This room is very secret Swiss bobsled training facility.
Oh, yeah, you think so?
Yeah.
Oh, you're right. There's the Swiss logo.
See? See, they did build it, Tom. It's just a little different.
Wow. You think you get all the big stuff in MK in one day with the extended hours? I think so.
If you are okay with waiting in line, yeah.
Yeah.
I do miss having the fast pass option where you know you can ride three things with a minimal weight.
Yeah.
Even if they're not like the headliners, you knew you had like three things you could do.
I agree. All right, guys, please hit that like button. We're 12 away from 100. We'd appreciate it. Looking at the GoPro and not paying attention.
I'm gonna have a shower now.
BB-8, prep the ready room for recruits. Commander 99, please report back to IGS cockpit.
Wow. resistance team led by my friend Finn has infiltrated a First Order Star Destroyer that is now headed to this system. Your outpost on Batu is no longer safe. We have transports waiting to take you to General Organa's secret base on Pakara. I'll regroup with you there. The Resistance desperately needs your help in our fight against Kylo Ren and the First Order. Remember, it is vital that you keep the location of the Pakara base secret. Lieutenant Beck, one of our top commanders, will lead you.
Affirmative. Transport is ready. Nine-Nom and I shall personally see them delivered.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Welcome to the cause. May the Force be with us.
Commander Poe Dameron and a squadron of X-Wings shall escort us to the rendezvous point on Pakara.
Roger, this is Black Leader. I hear you're a fine-looking group of recruits.
Yeah.
Well, no time to waste. Let's get you on your way to the General.
Stand clear. Deck doors opening now.
Hurry. All recruits to transport. No need for safety here. It'll be a smooth ride.
Stand on my day number.
People literally just like pushed past us, come around the back of us and pushed past us. Oh boy. People aren't ready to be outside yet. A specific number in the middle of a pandemic.
Engage repulsors and hold on, recruits. All ships launch. I am Lieutenant Beck. As you heard from Ray, I have been tasked with getting you to Pakara.
Red 2, Blue 5, keep tight now. Let's get ready to make that jump to light speed on my mark. Aboard the air, that I think, huh?
Black Leader, we're picking up an unusual signal.
Well, you can't see the back window. There's a family of like six blocking the whole back window. Sadly.
There appear to be a number of small craft heading our way. Raise the shields.
We have company, First Order TIE Fighters. Bring it up, bring it up.
I have a bad feeling about this. Stand back.
That was good. There's a real guy there, too. They're like hiding them in there now. That is the best idea. The best idea. Oh, I like that they're now just like posing with them and then do like the Horror Nights thing and just like pop out. Yeah, I got video.
No, of it on the street.
Of what? They saw it.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
I love it.
No, they saw it. It was great.
It's like my favorite thing.
It was really great.
Somebody here?
Two?
Two right this way along the wall.
Towards the front.
You guys can go towards the front. For spacing.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Leave us. Yes, General.
Laugh about a virus.
Enemies of the First Order, we will soon snuff out your meager resistance. You chose the wrong side, and now you will pay. The resistance prisoners.
You have what I want. You know the location of the secret base, and I will take it from you.
We're needed on the bridge.
Keep the prisoners here. I will return to finish this personally.
I'm gonna let them go.
Yeah, we'll just wait. We can wait. We will wait. I love them.
Well, this is going to be interesting. Well, I got in my car.
Oh my gosh, I knew you were going
to. We were going to get in two cars. We were going to get stuck here.
Oh, can
you believe this R5? Can you believe what I got to put up with?
But he seems confident.
I have faith. I believe.
We believe in you, R5.
Rebellions are built on hope.
Okay, take this corridor to the turbo lift, then head down to the escape pod base. Those droids are programmed to return you to Batuu. Hurry and don't get caught. Lieutenant Beck will guide you.
Recruits, for your safety, stay seated with seatbelts securely fastened. Keep hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the transport and supervise your children.
What?
Tell them it's a prisoner transfer. Did it work? Good. Now get a move on. There's a clear path to the turbo lift at the end of the hallway. Turn right. A probe droid. You're lucky it didn't spot you. Take those turbo lifts and stay out of trouble.
Hey, you're not on the right way.
no!
Take cover, recruits! If anyone's back in a blaster, now's a good time! Ah! The escape pods are full of us! Wait, why are you going up? I said down!
Took the elevator to the wrong floor!
The resistance will attempt to rescue the prisoners.
They have neither the resources nor the courage to engage us.
You underestimate their conviction. Raise the shields!
Shields? I see no evidence.
Now!
Sound the alarm! All personnel to their station!
Sir, the prisoners have escaped.
How brave. But ultimately hopeless. There's nowhere to run.
Come on, gun!
Yeah!
Well, they gotta see. The question is, will one cut us off? Huh? Yep! Wow! We are one animatronic away, pretty much everything working. Oh, come on! No! No! Goodbye, window man! Feel that they turn off the wind machines if you don't get the explosion?
Woo-hoo! You guys really like cutting it close, don't you? Okay, you're clear.
Your escape pods came in a little off target. Ground crews will meet you outside the wreck.
It's like when I parked the car.
All right, nice job, recruits. Not. I think about that authority. Right, Beck? Where's the lieutenant? I need eyes on Beck. Rhino, scat for his parking coach.
Eyes on Beck would be a great band name, by the way.
I should hope so. Great job, recruits. Thanks to your heroism, the location of the resistance base is secure. Bravo!
Yes, R5, you too!
Thank you,
R5. Let's hurry up before this family gets home. So close. Oh, Kylo worked, man.
I realized they didn't give them the mask. They made them special gray versions which have the same design.
Yeah.
I, like, never realized
that. Yep.
Apparently, I pay attention.
It's a new thing.
Oh, did they have them on?
They had them, yeah.
That's why I'm like, I've never seen them before. It looks great.
Well, still, I'm glad that it sounds like the stream held up better than ever in that ride. So that's wonderful.
Yeah, I mean,
that
your audio problems are fixed. So my theory.
Everything was good except Kylo. I think our connectivity being better is somehow linked to the ride running better. I think in the end the building wasn't conducive to the needs of the wireless ride system.
Right.
Yeah, it's a shame. We were so close.
Really bad. I mean, I'm never a big fan of that last AA anyhow. It looks like it's just like a
snail. Yeah, but I'd rather he be there than not be there.
Yeah. I'm just happy, like, the cannons. That's, like, one of
my... Yeah, it was nice to see the cannons for the first time in a while.
Yeah.
That's good. Maybe, you know, knock on wood with my parents' trip coming up, they may get a perfect ride. Gotta pray. My mother's one and only time on Indiana Jones, the damn boulder didn't work.
If it's, like, not perfect when your mother rides, okay.
I know, because she may never go again. She may not like the drop, and she might be like, I don't know. So you got one shot at this.
See, I find this drop, like, less intense than parts. It's so short.
She may not like the weightlessness, though.
Yeah.
That's the thing she doesn't like. Because that's what she didn't like about Radiator Springs Racers was like that. And that's not a big drop either. That, I think, is shorter than Pirates even.
It is.
Is it lunchtime?
Are you hungry?
I mean, we ordered, so we have to, like, redeem it at some point. That's probably what that's telling you.
Huh.
That it's time to tell them we're here and pick up our food. We should do that. Are you hungry? Yeah, we should. We told people we're going to take them to ABC. We're going to personally try the new items. We do have a review up already. Noelle, one of our reporters, went this week. Tried a bunch of the new stuff.
Yeah, we're going to try.
We're actually going to try something different today, the tofu curry bowl.
Did she not get that?
No, we got one tofu, one curry bowl. We did shrimp.
Oh, the shrimp.
Yeah. We don't, if there's, like, variations, we pick one, generally, especially if only one person's going to the review. We don't buy one person six entrees. We buy them three entrees like a normal person. Hit the button.
Okay.
Fire. Yes.
Okay. I'm sending my request. Five.
Shout
items.
Some.
Oh my god.
Shout some Pixar misquotes.
We're feasting.
Turn left to go right. My mask and start yelling. So long, cowboys. To infinity and some point further. Oh, look, we got some sausages coming up. Freshly made sausage. We're here, right? We'll see how long this takes to be admitted. We gotta see if, unlike other restaurants, will they let us in while we wait?
I don't know.
Let's go find out.
Is it like when they
do you wanna take this and I'll do this process?
I do, but hold on a second. Let's make sure the Wi-Fi. See? Hold on. Well, I don't know. The Wi-Fi went.
Okay. Here we go to the ABC commissary.
You might just have to play with the Wi-Fi.
I might have to.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, it says you're on airplane mode and nothing's actually happening. It says no internet connection. It doesn't really help us.
I usually just tell them it's not working. Might have to reconnect.
Table tracker Wi-Fi. I don't think
no.
That's the one. I think we stand on these red dots.
Oh yeah, look. Let's go in the corner.
Oh, Disney guest, we got it.
Come in the corner. Come in the corner. No.
Now it's saying no again. I just had it.
This is my...
Man, Disney Wi-Fi.
It's bad.
It's usually so reliable. I don't understand. All right, we're connected again. With preparing your order. Wait outside in front of the restaurant.
Let's go in the corner.
You want to go in the corner?
Yeah.
Go in the corner. This isn't actually shady.
Tom wants the other corner.
Get the red dot, man.
When's the last time you ate here?
There was a period where I ate here a lot when the salmon was.
They used to have that great kids' meal,
the salmon.
And you would pick two sides.
Double steak fries.
Yeah. It was like $8, and the salmon was so good.
That was my go-to.
Not at all fishy. It was a tremendous amount of food. That's my favorite noise.
Is Commissary Lane technically the smallest land in any Disney film?
Yeah. I mean...
It still hasn't been lumped in anything else. This even says Commissary Lane on it.
There's a Commissary, there's Sci-Fi, there's the Red Carpet, which...
Is on Commissary
No.
Lane, is it? Yeah, it is.
There's Red Carpet, which is closed. Yeah, Baseline. That's it.
Yeah, I guess there are technically three things in this land, despite it being just an alley. So it's Commissary, Sci-Fi, and the part of dreams are Commissary Lane.
They should take this.
Because someone had that argument where they said, like, oh, something is the only land in a park without an attraction. And I was like, Commissary
well,
Lane doesn't...
Well, Red Carpet Dreams is normally... Room. That counts as an attraction. Entertainment's not an attraction?
Correct.
That's incorrect.
That's not entertainment. That's it's
an incorrect
it's
fact.
It's not a show. It's not
but it's
attraction.
A something to do.
That doesn't mean it. A water play area is something to do. A water play area is not an attraction.
It's like an e-ticket. A water play
you
area
see,
is
an e-ticket.
You're
telling me the liquid layer at Epcot is
well,
attraction.
Liquid layer is probably the best one. It's my favorite. My Hog in the Dot.
What about Hog in the Dot?
We give the order number away. Someone's gonna go steal our food.
I'm sure someone's gonna steal mine.
I'm excited.
Yeah, so much.
We had some good meals in here. Shockingly.
I'm excited. Mateo talked up this sandwich.
Did he?
I'm excited to tell him he's wrong. About this.
I liked maybe 8 to 10 years ago when they had that arugula quinoa bowl.
Oh, I lost life.
My life.
They really should have amped up the Wi-Fi over here if they were going to do more water in there.
I ate that arugula quinoa bowl for so long. And then they got rid of it, and then I boycotted this place for like 4 or 5 years.
That's the famous arugula boycott of 95.
That's right, I would get it, and I would sit right there, out there, and it was perfect. Perfect. What's everyone else having for brunch?
This is brunch, ABC Commissary Brunch.
Unlimited mimosas, right? They want to know what's better, primetime or sci-fi, Tom?
Oh, I like sci-fi better, but I like them both a lot.
I like sci-fi better also. Yeah, there was a period they had like this, what they called a Asian chicken salad here with the mandarin oranges.
Yeah,
that was not good though.
No, it was one of the worst meals I've ever had in my life.
That was the dark times here.
Surf and turf burger?
Oh.
A burger topped with fried shrimp.
That's a you and Josh thing. I'm not getting involved in that.
Josh. I didn't even know
before Josh was born.
I didn't even know Josh. For the surf and turf burger.
Oh, someone's having avocado toast. I love avocado toast. Scotch egg someone's having? That sounds good.
They'll yell at us when
they're just gonna be yelling, Tom! Tom, come get your food!
The mean man, please come retrieve your order. The mean man.
I liked when the background music in here had like the like Sunday night football music. In Dallas. Oh my god, that's like some dancing music.
I remember we sat at Backlot, like it was the week before. I think we knew the loop was going, and I was sitting there eating, and I was like, this is the last time I'm going to hear this Dallas song. And anywhere.
Breakfast Baconator. Half a Breakfast Baconator.
Wendy's?
I'm not sure what that means.
Is it Haston?
Cheerios with blueberries and Dunk's iced Haston coffee. Oh, that sounds good, Don.
Very exciting live stream of the entrance to EDC Commissary. We're still.
What?
Tuck your leg.
Someone's dog likes when the pork talks.
Her Millennium Celebration fanny
pack. Oh, gosh. Oh, she is styling today.
My assistant would say that's sick.
House, they want to know, how is Chef Art Smith? Someone has it booked.
I like Homecoming. I'm a fan. I like Moonshine. I'm a big Moonshine guy.
I liked it pre-pandemic.
It's fine. He learned his lesson. It's fine. Yeah.
Where's Porg Froman? He's on my shoulder. Someone says, I don't know why, but I like the vibe of the ABC Writer's Place thing. It feels like Streets of America.
Oh,
yeah.
Writer's Stop is gone. I mean, this does, yeah. I mean,
but yeah, we still have that old
vibe.
Old which is kind of why we're here, subconsciously, I think.
You gotta support old MGM.
Tell them I want to eat counter service.
You know, we'd be served at a table service.
Yeah, I know.
How long have we hit the book?
Should we go check? Do you want to go check?
I mean, it says it's still, she's calling me.
Oh, okay. Sometimes, like, the connection.
I think it's fine.
Okay.
We didn't order just a soda, so I have faith that it'll...
Docking Bay 7 has a few great dishes.
Maybe they didn't
have
tofu ready. I don't know that the tofu is a big seller.
Why not?
I just don't think a lot of people in this theme park crowd eat tofu.
Okay. Yeah, the child's tip, yeah, but Docking Bay 7, that's a great dish. I like the macaroni and cheese that comes with that, yeah.
I'm gonna try this today, see if we like this.
I've only been to Docking Bay like once or twice since reopening, shockingly. The tippy up salad is good. There it is. All right. Thank you. Thank you. He is hungry.
Get this back to you.
Sure. I'm not allowed to carry the tray, guys, because bad things will happen. Thank you. I'll carry that bottle. Thank you.
I'm so used to the old one.
I know. Oh, look. Family Feud. So we get our drinks over here.
I don't think I've even eaten here since they built the drink stations.
Right. And could we have a water with no ice also, please? Thank you. I can carry something else.
I got it. It's a Claire dish. It's just a times the size of the one. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. There's the best banner. The mural, I mean. Palm trees. Tom, you're so good at carrying the tray. I guess I need to get cutlery, right?
Yeah. I send you on the mission.
For sure.
Very important. Thanks for joining the cause.
Thanks for joining the cause.
I'm going to be very excited. You're going to be very excited for Bastogne? Which brand?
What is this, guys?
Oh, it's the good one from Pecos. I think it's the one from Pecos.
We can't see your head. You're cut off.
I don't know your position. I can
there we go.
Sit down.
There he is. Here's your hot sauce.
What is the good one that Pecos has? Monum.
So that's Tom's
sauce. It ties into the Godzilla movie.
Shirt he was telling you about earlier.
Okay.
It's a nice red.
You want to show them the food first?
Yeah. You can put that down and I'll come show you.
Mm-hmm. It looks good. I think it looks very good.
I'm excited to eat this. Look, actual vegetables. It looks like actual food.
What is the sauce?
It looks like a cheese.
Is it cheese? I don't think it's cheese.
What's that?
Is that the buffalo sauce? Am I supposed to take it?
So there's chicken and grilled cheese?
Yeah, there's chicken.
And steak fries. I love steak fries.
Steak fries, which are the same as sci-fi, by the way.
Yeah, you're right. Tofu probably is not food. I agree.
What is the name of tofu?
It's soy.
Okay.
Someone will give us more information, I'm sure. And then, the real reason I want to be here.
Yeah, you'll undo the tofu with this.
Chocolate eclair.
You love bones.
U.S. foods.
You love food with bones.
This is funny because I went to Banana Cabana and there was a bone in my chicken sandwich. This is great.
Sorry, one time I went to Fantastic Four Cafe and there was a rock in the bone.
What kind of rock?
Oh, a kind of key meat.
Okay.
Have you seen your phone? I'll look at the menu.
Of what it is?
Yeah, I want to see. I'm sure that's the buffalo sauce. So there's an orange tinge to the salmon.
Do we want to take some pics?
I would like you to take some pictures of yours.
Here.
I don't have pictures of yours.
Take pics of yours too. Take
pics. We have pictures.
Take more. The life of the blogger. You have to flip it around. That way. There you go. Come back and go two times. This is terrible lighting. Normally we would carry all this stuff outside to take photos of it.
It's not bad if
you... Yeah.
A shadow. Give me your phone.
You want to take that out? Outside?
No.
There we go. Do we have this already?
Yeah, we had that when it debuted at Backlot.
Oh, it was at Backlot? Cool.
The studios always share desserts between the counters.
Mm-hmm. It's nice being back in here.
I want to see this. You can start here.
I want to take a panda picture.
Grilled sourdough toast with buffalo chicken, Monterey, provolone, cheddar, and cream cheese served with a side of buffalo sauce.
Buffalo sauce. I didn't know buffaloes had sauce.
Someone in the comments did. You know buffalo and buffalo.
I just feel bad for the poor buffaloes. Oh, is it?
That comes on my chicken.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. I mean, they're connected. The kitchen is connected.
Yeah. They're looking at the food because you're pointing to it. Whoops. Now they can watch you eat on camera. So on my bowl, the rice is good. It's just rice. The rice is rice.
The rice is rice.
Mm-hmm. Try the rice.
Another excellent WDW review. The rice is rice.
The tofu is good. It's less like crispy than the I know. You like rice that is
it's
just
really soft and buttery.
It's not buttery. It's just rice. But this
that's
like.
How you get it.
Oh, I don't put rice in my or butter in my rice. I mean.
That's butter. That's for sure. It's very good. It's very soft.
I like the tofu though, because like, it's different than like satouli. Satouli's is more crispy. This is a little bit softer on the outside, almost like Skipper Canteen crew stew. It's good.
That's what I was going to say. It looks like the crew stew.
It's plentiful too. Like, this is a lot of tofu. What type of curry is this supposed to be? Like, curry just means stew. Oh, it's nice. You must try. Yeah, try like a vegetable. There's carrots and there's squash. And well, you don't want the onion, I'll eat that. Zucchini. It's a good sauce. It's not spicy, but it has like a warmth to it.
Reminds me a lot of Casbah.
A little bit, yeah. I guess you're supposed to like mix that.
I mean, it's a curry bowl.
See, we're like lacking curry bowls at Walt Disney World.
There's more people here on the curry bowls.
Just stew. That's what I love about Tokyo. Each park you can get like, you know, protein rice. Now back to your food.
This happened to me very good. Wanna try?
Okay. No.
More than a bargain for. There you go.
It is good. It's super cheesy. Very different than like Beaches and Cream. Beaches and Cream is like, I think I prefer Beaches and Cream. This tastes a little more artificially cheese. I would come here. Okay, they can watch you eat again. I can't do this. I would get this again. I think I might like this bowl better than Docking Bay 7. For me personally, when I don't want to eat meat.
I like my salad.
Your tippy up salad. Like salad. This is just like warm comfort food. Tippy up forever. Like, but in the winter, like the heartiness of the curry and the warmth of the sauce. Like when we come for Osborne Lights, Tom, I'm gonna get this every night.
I'm curious about the tacos, but I feel like they've just got to be the stuff from...
We can have dinner here at 4:30.
No.
The shrimp tacos?
I have the same sauce on chicken.
I just like the option of being able to eat like real food in the theme park at a counter service that's not like fried or too greasy. What? That's like real food?
This?
Kind of.
This is fancy. That's probably what I should have every time I come.
We do have to try the shrimp.
Yeah, I just appreciate it. I appreciate these things that aren't salads with kale.
Mm-hmm.
That are healthy, like variation.
Mm-hmm.
The variety.
Because
I'm not like a big salad guy. But I would eat a tofu bowl every day.
Mm-hmm.
I just that's my thing. Like I love
we
rice.
Love bowls.
Rice with sauce and I make tofu.
Mm-hmm. Have another tofu. There's so much. You never had a tofu.
No, you never did. You told me to take a squash. They all are.
Poor Tom. I'm mistreating him again. You don't like it because it's not crispy on the outside. It's a little softer.
You
like it crispy.
It needs to be cooked. It's not bad.
Yeah.
But honestly, shrimp's not that bad for you.
The shrimp's good. Good for you. Protein?
Yeah. I wonder if I told him I had like soy and chicken allergies or thing, or soy and shrimp allergies. They make me a chicken.
What else do they have chicken in?
They have chicken in their kitchen, so. If this was the chicken, I could have this every day.
I mean,
I'm really surprised in that variation that doesn't exist, right? Because if we go back to...
Maybe it's because of price. Maybe the chicken's too expensive.
If we go back to Satouli, where the original Satouli menu was chicken, beef, and a fish and a tofu, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so here you have a fish and tofu.
Yeah, that's true.
Chicken version, I think, would be a nice option. You wouldn't slow down the kitchen, right?
Yeah. Oh, there's a piece of potato in here, even. Look at that.
Yeah.
Potato.
What's the chat talking about?
Let's see, sauce. This sauce is nice because it's super flavorful, so you don't need a lot of it. Like, just a little bit goes a long way, which is better.
I like my rice.
You can mix it up. You can mix it up.
I would probably add some
extra sauce. You know, this is plenty for me. Well, I can watch you eat again. Dawn says she's glad she can actually come back here again now. I am happy for that reason, too.
Yeah, that was a shame.
Air-conditioned dining. I mean, you might not want to eat indoors, right? Not
this
everyone does. Mm-hmm.
This menu was good for a while. It was sad when they started doing that crazier barbecue stuff again.
Yeah, the barbecue was a bad choice here.
People love the rims, though, the value.
Mm.
But the nice thing was that the ribs lived in conjunction with the salmon and the other dishes.
I think I like this better than the kid's salmon double steak fry, even. Just because when you eat double steak fries, you know, you feel it after.
Feel this after.
It's good to have, like, comfort food. This is all comfort food. The grilled cheese, curry.
Those are Tony's, which is all discomfort.
This is kind of a winter menu. Like, the vegetables in here. Zucchini, carrots, squash, potato, onion.
This is why we don't eat on camera. I'm really excited.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But I think I agree with our review.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's good.
It's nice to have another counter service option.
Mm-hmm. We were talking one time about what are the most consistent and the most inconsistent restaurants, and this has to be the most inconsistent restaurant, no?
I mean, they didn't let it be consistent. They kept changing the menu.
Mm-hmm.
Someone commented, actually, posted about the new menu, like, isn't this the 8th menu in like 4 years? And they said, probably that. We did the same thing with Backlot, too. Not Backlot.
Someone says Hollywood Studios quick services always get a bad rap, but they enjoy them. I agree with that. More than, I enjoy Studios quick service more than MK.
Rosie's and Pizza Rizzo are actually trash.
I like the fried green tomato sandwich at Rosie's. Back when you could get it with no side because none of the sides are edible.
I think dining at this park was so bad at that time that everyone was willing to give that green tomato sandwich.
Yeah. And that was also after Hungry Bear took it off their menu. So it was like, oh wow, we have another fried green tomato sandwich.
The Fairfax menu change was not bad when they did the Tex Mex.
Yeah, I mean,
it was very pickles.
Fairfax salad. Eat more of my bowl.
Oh, I missed the Fairfax salad.
No.
Finish this. Eat.
Oh, someone has an Oga's for Friday.
Yeah.
We'll be there. Let's see if I can walk up Ballista. Let's see. The cinnamon roll at Oga's is excellent. And someone misses Studio Catering Company. Those were the days. At Studio Catering Company? Chicken strips or nuggets, some fried chicken matter. There was a salad that was bad. mint julep from Casey's Corner. Now you guys are talking. That frozen mint julep is so good. It was just not something if I went there, it was disappointing. I liked the bar, the Studio Catering Company bar. High octane refreshments. Thank you. Those were some good bartenders. Every drink I got there was like quadruple pour.
High octane refreshments have the Osborne drinks that were good. The snowball? Snow something. It was really good.
Just out there. I'm getting it closer so that you'll be louder on for their audio.
Can you hear me? I would buy the mic thing, but it seems we would only need it for when we do this.
Which we try not to
do. People can hear me all the time.
Usually you're very loud.
Well, we're inside a restaurant. I'm not trying not to.
I know.
Speak loud enough to bother. I know. The only reason I really don't want to vlog is I've been to a lot of restaurant opening and people are just yelling.
I know.
And I'm like, people around you are eating and are not here for a review to be, you know, not interfere with the guest experience.
Tom went to get a soda refill. Are the fries good? We'll ask him when he comes back. I guess I can eat one. That's not gonna focus. They're okay. I ate a French fry. They wanted to know, are the fries good, Tom?
They're wonderful. For those of you who don't know my usual sci-fi order, I actually like to get the sauce chicken tender appetizer with the side of the steak fries. It's relatively cheap and it's very good. I also leave room for dessert.
What do you want to do after lunch?
I don't know. Hollywood Studios, what can we do about a 3-hour lunch?
can go visit Gertie.
I mean, that takes 2 minutes.
Visit her again. So the dishes here are the same dishes as Sci-Fi, because they changed the dishes at Sci-Fi.
That's right, yeah. This is almost like eating at Sci-Fi, well, not eating at Sci-Fi.
It is. Oh my God. Poor baby.
What part works for me? You know, I have to stay quiet.
Oh, honey.
That's very good.
Who's here for?
For this bony eclair.
What's it called?
Meso bones eclair. Probably. Meso bones, I think, is the name of the ribs at.
Is that where you told me I should try the ribs?
A lot of people like them. Yeah. That's perfect. I find that usually in most eclairs that it's a sealed pastry, not one where you cut the lid off.
Okay, it's a box of bones chocolate eclair.
Okay. It's a nightmare reference, no?
I guess. All right, try it.
Go ahead.
Me?
Yeah.
You're not gonna eat it?
I'll try it.
You're an unwilling participant in this dessert. The structural integrity. You're
gonna
have to cut it for
me. You hit a ligament.
What? That's so gross. It's good enough.
This is junk.
But it's chocolate and there's bones.
No, this is garbage. This is like eating chocolate mousse.
I like the mousse. This eclair is not fresh enough. The bones are fine.
Nope. No.
Another positive review. You know what? Can I just say, speaking of negative reviews and bad restaurants, this is better than the dessert we had at Chef de France.
It was pretty bad.
This is better.
This is terrible.
And it's still better than the dessert we had at Chef de France.
Still bad.
Edit.
You know, because I don't, you know, I obviously don't always agree with, you know, reporters. Everyone has a different
It's an
base,
opinion. And I like this more than you do, so.
I think this is great.
I think it's edible. It's fine. It's as I expected. But this is a...
It tastes like cardboard. It's like
the mousse is good, though. Like communion. He's dead.
See, it's no good. This is probably what main sauce would be at this point.
It's like a little mouth. Fresh enough. Yes. Here. You can give your thoughts.
My thoughts are to not get this eclair, in case that wasn't clear yet. Those are my thoughts. I'm sticking to them. You're still eating it?
The mousse part is very good. It's like dug
no,
in there.
Don't give me more.
There's a lot of mousse in there, though. No, the white chocolate tastes like dust. It's like chalky dust. Have you had my cooking?
No.
Because he's a smart man.
No, because you don't cook. Yeah, everything in this meal was great except for the dessert, which shouldn't really be helpful to this restaurant because it debuted before this restaurant was even.
Mm-hmm.
I would recommend eating some commissary for lunch if you want commissary. I still like Docking Bay better, but this is a good other option. Sometimes Docking Bay's crazy. I love that salad. I would eat that salad. It's high praise, I think, because earlier I told everybody, except you don't really like salad. That is a salad I would eat every day. That and the Cobb salad.
Okay, so hold on. Tom doesn't like salad. He comes to studios, he has one of three things if he's by himself. Chicken Caesar salad at 50s, yeah. Cobb salad at Brown Derby, yeah. Or Tip Yip salad at Docking Bay 7. I don't like salad.
The Caesar, not that it's bad, but I find them easily like the chicken Caesar, so I feel like I can have a milkshake and not die.
Yeah, no, that makes sense.
Yeah, no, these happen to be Cobb salad and then other salad happens to be very good.
Yeah, you like good salads.
I don't eat salad in other parts.
Because they don't have good salads.
That's fair, yeah. Maybe I just haven't been exposed to a lot of good creative salads in my time. Disneyland, everyone likes that taco salad. Everyone raves it.
It's not that good.
Rancho Del Zoco.
Oh, I'm full.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That was
a big meal, that sandwich. That sandwich is more than enough. You probably split that with someone, I don't know. Especially with the steak fries, it's such a big heavy meal.
Yeah,
for sure. No, this is great.
Our two kids could split
it. I'll come to that curry bowl at some point. I'm going to see if I get them to do chicken. I'm going to try.
You won't be able to mobile order, though. You'll have to come in.
No, but I bet I can.
If you come at open, somewhere. Like at 10:30.
I want to get them to put it on the menu. I just think with chicken, that would be a real good idea. It's a chicken-like menu, too.
Well, I mean, everywhere else is so chicken-heavy. What?
The Mediterranean salad has the good
chicken. Oh, it does.
They'll just throw it in for me. They'll do this. It exists already. The grilled chicken exists. They just have to throw it in the bowl.
You and your off menu.
I'm gonna do it.
You're turning into me, ordering off menu.
I just like that's what I eat at home.
It's
like
true.
A chicken bowl with rice and corn. And I feel like a chicken curry bowl with rice and vegetables. I'd really love it. Hopefully, whoever's watching today from the Walt Disney Company is taking notes. He suggested this chicken bowl. I think it's a new thing.
Is this old or new?
I got it. It's coming.
Look at wait times.
Oh, we're looking at wait time. You want me to guess them?
Guess the wait times. You have to go from lowest to highest, and you have to get them all. No, you have to get the order correct.
No, I'm going to go attraction by attraction.
All right.
Railway's going to be 90.
Yes.
That's right?
That's right.
Is it absolutely right?
Yeah, it's absolutely right.
Wow, cool.
Have some faith in yourself.
What time is it?
It's 12:04. Where's your pocket watch, honey?
Star Tours is going to be 20.
Incorrect.
40?
45.
Wow. Smuggler's Run is 45.
No.
60?
No.
More?
75.
70. Wow. Tower's got to be 60.
No. 55. You're close.
What is Rockin's gonna be? Rockin's gonna be 90.
70.
Okay.
Dash?
80.
90. Swirling saucer?
Saucer's 30.
25.
Yeah,
Muppet five. Vision?
10.
30.
Oh my god, get out of here.
Oh, Mania?
30.
50. You started off so strong.
I was moving five on a lot. Smuggler.
I'm proud of you.
They got railway exactly right.
Well, because they always leave it on the same wait time. It's either 90, 110, or 120.
A couple. They all don't.
I know.
Actually, do 5-minute intervals. It's not really. A lot of it's guesstimation, especially the ones that have the magic band integration aren't even working.
I know. Well, let's go buy some dresses, Tom.
I'm gonna finish my soap.
Yeah, okay. I'm gonna run there then.
How are you? I'm pretty much done.
Then we can go.
Absolutely. I'm pretty sure they're going to take it from you though, because
yeah, I know.
They're reusable plates.
And he's going to want to clean the table.
I might just tell you where you are.
We'll
What'd you do? You knocked over Pork Froman?
He died.
He died? That was from the bone in the eclair. The bone in the eclair got him. Yeah. Did you put it on correctly? Got it, I'll head outside. Maskless lady. If you enjoyed lunch with us, please hit the like button. If you didn't, please let us know. We'll stop eating on camera. Good, you ready? Where are we off? Just head this way. Let's go. Do you want to go to the dress shop?
Yeah.
Even though I looked in the window already and didn't see anything new. Yeah, that was good. I think we timed it right too. It looks pretty busy out here. Yeah. Well, we were going to go right at open, but then our Rise group was called, like, right at 10:20. I do remember that.
Because that was the one where I was like, wait, this is the third fountain covered in plastic.
Yeah. Remember the day it was so cold they had to have them all taped to run?
I remember.
Because the pipes were going to freeze? Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
That was a fun day, too.
That was so funny.
Yeah.
And then it's like, you guys know in Paris, like, the water can run. It's going to be okay, Florida. It was like 60 degrees and it was still running with them.
These pipes may not be made for it, though.
Yeah, true.
Well, she has two sausages.
Whoa, that's cool.
They must be super hungry.
Yeah, I love making that. Well, you get, like, the spicy one and then, like, the sweeter one, right?
The hot link? Is this, like, Corn Dog Castle?
Oh, no. Is one of them filled with cheese, though?
Mm. Oh, there's the cheese stick. Yeah. Duffy had a mask. It's, you can't do it here because it's so far between them that it's hard to even tell.
You kind of got to do this one in person. It's very
simple. Adventureland was easy because the speakers are near each other.
Yeah.
So literally, once you take enough steps, it just morphs.
But if you come on your own, this green one here on the right is the last one of the modern sound, and then you have to go three windows down to Keystone. And that's the next speaker.
Well, let's go to Keystone.
Okay.
We haven't been in here for a stream yet.
Let's get Marvel stuff.
Who likes Marvel and or Star Wars?
No.
Oh. Okay.
I love their costumes.
Fashion spot.
Fashion.
This one's based on the Max Factor building, I think.
Yeah.
Two, yep. Thanks.
Thank you.
Let's start on the Marvel side. Aw, Deidre, thank you. When we talked to the people who did the shop interiors, they said, like, we don't really want to make them that plain either. It's just a directive, yeah. It's the Groot wall.
Do you
you remember on opening day of Galaxy's Edge last year in August, the citizens of Hollywood were in here, like, picking up all the Star Wars merch and being, like,
yeah,
making fun of it?
Yeah.
That's, like,
yeah.
I miss it.
Yeah. I've never seen this.
I was just gonna say.
I have never, I'm not doubting it was probably one of the things that was only in, okay, one of the things that was only in here, but.
It's not new.
Oh, this is crazy. On this side is Marvel, and on this side is Star Wars. It's a weird thing that doesn't happen in a lot of places. Not the cavalcade, I know. I know. Does Admiral Akbar have a selfie stick? What is... Yeah. I've never seen Admiral Akbar with a selfie stick before.
I thought they weren't allowed in the park.
Well... Does Disney still sell Vinylmation, Deidre? No, they don't. No, those are gone now. Completely gone. Oh, this is just the spinny one. Oh, this is... There we go. That was weird. Well, we lost the whole audience. That's great. Thanks, YouTube. And I know we had full service, so it definitely wasn't our connection. Yeah, thanks, YouTube. Definitely, again, in case people missed it, I just want to make it clear that we had full service, full bars, and it wasn't connecting back to it, so YouTube must have went down for a moment.
Yeah. It was tripping.
Do you want to go in here? Look at what?
Around the base. Do they like pick these up and reconcrete underneath and then put them
back?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's so weird. I've never seen it like that. I love that.
They got rid of that exit that was on the floor.
Yeah.
Five. The epic friendship.
Oh my gosh.
You want Disney's Hollywood Studio?
I am so loving this.
How much would this cost? It's a lot of letters.
We can ask. Do you want any of this?
No,
you're going to wear that.
I don't need it.
But like, what's on it? There's the popcorn, the alien.
Yeah.
I don't really like Pandora.
No, I'm just joking.
But this is funny. And this one they did with the sorcerer.
They still make a sorcerer's hat. I think when they started the Pandora deal, though, there still was a sorcerer's hat.
One of the...
Yeah.
Okay.
Disney Parks exclusives.
So, but they're not Disney stuff.
Hmm. Some great shirts. These are bottom shelf now, probably rightfully so. Yeah, I know YouTube's broken because the last super chat is now just like stuck to the top. Yeah. They have the boxers slash pajamas slash whatever here. The new ones.
Another iteration.
They always, Grumpy sells well, so they just always keep making more Grumpy.
They do.
Here they are.
What are these?
What are what? Oh, those are pajama shorts.
Pajama shorts.
Yeah, with the Walt Disney World, yeah. In the very popular yellow. I'm surprised they made that for men. That's big with the ladies, the yellow Walt Disney World. Boxer boots. These run giant, by the way. I think I would fit in the small ones. These are small. Look how big they are.
The Kevin ones are cute, too. I like the art. The Kevin art.
Are people still having issues? Star Wars and graffiti. I don't make the merchandise. I just look at it.
He just buys it.
I just buy it. Oh, here's more of the lounge pants. Marvel's gotten real big on these just circular icons for heroes.
These are soft.
Yeah, they're.
But when we did
Look at the play pavilion.
What was the thing we did at DCA where I got the Doctor Strange?
Oh, the like scavenger hunt thing? Yeah, I remember that. That was a thing for a bit. There's more stuff in this Mickey and Co. line. I kind of like this.
Do you like
it's
it?
Very 90s, yeah.
Looks like Disneyland Paris.
I don't know, it's all like very 90s. I'm a big fan of the 90s clothing. Yeah. Oh, boy. Well, it says, oh, boy. Where dreams come true, time to Disney. Good vibes only. Park bound.
What's this shirt that just says yeah?
Oh, we got super chat. Lily Disney, Tom, are you live streaming this coming week of the parks any days? This is my fourth attempt to get a super chat to go through. Darn. Yeah, I think they're having problems, Legally Disney. I'm streaming. When am I streaming this week? That's a great question. I have to look at the schedule. Sugar, spice, and everything ice. It's something.
I like the castle art on the miniature.
Yeah? Yeah, it's pretty. It kind of looks like they're real colors. It's now. Some reminders for you guys. If you're liking the stream, please hit the like button. If you haven't yet, please subscribe. We're live from a Walt Disney World theme park Resort or Disney Springs every day. And if you really like what we're doing, just like Legally Disney did, you can leave us a super chat or become a member of our Inner Globe Society at patreon.com/WDWNT. They get a discount on any size order from carouselproducts.com. A great benefit. And if you haven't yet, please shop with carouselproducts.com. We've got orange and lime garage magnets on sale for you this week. In a couple days, we'll have some more products. Every Thursday, we release more product for you. It's Bio Reconstruct. There he goes. And make the San Fernando Valley my home. Ba ba da ba ba da ba. Hey, remember Fantasmic?
Remember when they put that ugly billboard up there?
Yeah.
Like this street crossing for the Tower of Terracue, because there is like the stop.
That's light. Actually on a real street crossing.
Right.
That's where it would be.
It's
yeah.
My favorite.
It's pretty great.
I mean, it's not dinking right now, but.
Yeah.
It's only 40 minutes, which is not that bad.
Yeah.
For a tower.
Where are we headed?
I don't know.
I think probably away from this corner of the park.
Probably away.
Are people still having problems? Is YouTube still having issues? Who is this character that has the cavalcade today?
The blue dress person?
I don't. Yeah, what's the name of this thing?
Who knows? Person with a blue dress.
I don't know. I just figure it's all formulaic at this point. Like. Skrskajgabum of Lublublum. I don't know. Anymore.
Disney Junior is not real Disney character anymore.
It's a Disney Junior party. Alright. We're gonna feed a therapy in the starlight. You know it's gonna be a magical time. This is Rock and Roller Coaster all the way down here. Yeah, detective, I don't know. Ace Ventura, pet detective. I don't know.
I'm gonna run to the restroom.
Eleanor of Avalon.
I'll find you.
I'm gonna go on the main boulevard and see if this thing's gonna come.
Okay.
Mira. It's Detective Mira?
Mira Max?
I don't know. Mira, pet detective. Hey, Ace, you got any more of that gum? It's a personal question, Dan, and I'll ask you to stay out of my affairs. It's not the secret society of newborn royals or second-born royals or whatever. That's a movie on Plus. Yeah, Mira. Mira Costa. Mira Aj. I'm gonna come up with all sorts of names for this character. This lady's wearing a shirt that says stay home. She's currently out at Hollywood Studios. She has a shirt that says stay home. See any signs of life down here. The weather may not be just right for this cavalcade. Let's go ask Bo when the cavalcade is. Did you get to experience the Adventurers Club? Not a little bit originally. I went in for like 30 minutes, but we did host a reunion of the Adventurers Club for its 30th anniversary at Pleasure Beach, where we had many of the original members. You can actually watch that right here on our YouTube channel. Here's Bo. Bo, when is the cavalcade? You don't know? Bo don't know. Bo don't know when Mira's coming. Yeah, Bo is my source on all everything. Yeah, the weather doesn't look great. I bet that's why there's no cavalcades coming at the moment. I'm seeing no movement. I think the weather is good for Mira. Should we wait here? Should we move on?
We can wait a bit. Let's...
Okay.
See Bo.
I saw Bo. We said hello to Bo already.
It's
flat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where do you want to shoot it from?
Probably from here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, guys. We're going to go film. Got to film this cavalcade for the channel and for the site. It's really the only newsworthy thing going on here today. So we're going to go for now. We'll see you tomorrow. I don't know if I'm streaming tomorrow. No, I'm off tomorrow. Tuesday I'm streaming. I forget who's streaming tomorrow. I know I'm on Tuesday. Tuesday I'll be back with you. But someone will be here for you tomorrow. And we'll see you then.